Very good evening. In this particular segment, I would like to give you information regarding that agriculture economics in part 1 and part 2. If possible, if some more information are available, so this may extend it to that part 3 also. So this is mainly in the angle of that general agriculture point of view. This data will be useful for you, the ICAR, JRF as well as SRF examinations. The agriculture economics, so many programs are started by the government of India, and all those things I will try to give you. So in that, the first one is Kisan Seva Kendra, that is a KSK. So this program is started by Indian Oil Corporation Limited. So that Indian Oil Corporation Limited, they started rural retail outlets. So this is mainly to provide the micro ATM facilities or fertilizer pesticide shop kind of things and farm equipment facilities for the rural customers. So it's a facilitation center for rural customers. So through that facilitation center, they are offering that micro ATM facilities, fertilizer and pesticides and farm equipments. At present, totally 8,044 number of KSK is available and in operation in India. So this also comes under the Ministry of that Petroleum and Natural Gases. So that is Kisan Seva Kendra, KSK. Then another one, it's Maitri, MAITRI, that is Indo-Brazil Agritech Cross-Border Incubation Program. Jointly launched by Pusa Krishi Incubator, that is a technology business incubator of the IRA and Embassy of Indo-Brazil. So they jointly launched this particular 6 months mentoring program in the year 2019, the month of December 9, at National Agricultural Science Center Complex. So the mentoring program will be conducted both at Delhi and Brazil. So the main aim of this Maitri program, that is MAITRI program, is a global innovation partnership and a collaboration initiatives in the field of agriculture by Pusa Krishi Incubator at ICAR-IRA. So this program is designed with an intent to create deep impact on global innovation landscape and address the critical issues in agriculture. Apart from that Maitri will work as a knowledge and exchange platform between countries, academia, industries and practitioners and a new business and innovation entrepreneurs. So this also aiming for identifying some youth, and they will be given with some entrepreneurship related trainings. So that is a Maitri program. It's an international program jointly organized by the Pusa Krishi Incubator. Pusa Krishi Incubator is a technology business incubator of the ICAR-IRA and Embassy of the Indo-Brazil. They started this particular program. In line with Maitri, that Pusa Krishi Incubator, they are also offering other three programs like ARISE 2020, ARISE 2020. That particular program is aiming for early stage agri startups and aim to promote innovation and entrepreneurships. So this also a entrepreneurship development program. Then another program, UPJA, that is a holistic incubation program for agri startup at pre-commercialization stage with a minimum valuable products. That is a UPJA. Then another program, that is SAMARTH, SAMARTH. So this is a trainer training programs. So here under this program, that incubator management program for new incubators and incubation managers. So this is a program for the new incubators and incubation managers. So these are all the programs offered by the Pusa Krishi Incubator. Pusa Krishi Incubator is a technology business incubator of the ICAR-IARI. Then another program, that is a Maharashtra state specific program, that is SMART, SMART. The full form SMART is State of Maharashtra's Agri Business and Rural Transformation. Actually, this program is funded by the World Bank and the Livelihood Project for Rural Maharashtra. So this particular program was formulated by Maharashtra Village Social Transformation Foundation, that is MVSTF, and Maharashtra State Rural Livelihood Mission, that is MSRLM, and Maharashtra Agricultural Competitiveness Project, MACP, all the three joined together. They started this particular program. Mainly this program is offered to improve the livelihood of the rural Maharashtra. So the main objective of that SMART is to support value addition in the post-harvest segment of the agriculture value chain and facilitation of the agribusiness investment through that inclusive business model that provide opportunity to small farmers and stimulate the establishment of the small and medium enterprises and support for climate resilient agriculture. Because of that, climate change is a major threatening factor as far as that agriculture is concerned. So in order to overcome that climate change threatening, all those things, they are aiming to provide some sort of support to the farming community. So these are all the objectives of the SMART program. So SMART program, it's a state specific, Maharashtra state specific program funded by the World Bank. Then AgMark online systems, already you may aware of that. AgMark is a quality certification mark for agriculture produce. So in AgMark system, that Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, they launched online software for processing of the applications. So through online systems, that applicant, they can get a certificate of authorization, permission of printing press, permission of laboratory and services, and laboratory information management systems, everything they are providing through online. Apart from that, the applicant also, they can make their payment through the online, that is e-transfer. So for transfer of that money, that applicant, they have to use that website, that bharatkosh.gov.in. So through that website, they can make a payment. So this is a AgMark online system. So now AgMark is made it in a online. And then SARC Agri Cooperative Business Forum held at Kathmandu, Nepal during 28 to 13th August, the first time in the history. So first SARC Cooperative Agri Cooperative Business Forum held at Kathmandu the year 2018. So the representatives from Ministry of Agriculture and Department of Cooperative of the member states of the SARC and representative of the farmers organization from SARC regions attended this particular forum. The main theme of this particular forum is organizing and strengthening family farmers cooperative to attain sustainable development goals 1 and 2 in South Asia. That sustainable development goal is proposed by the UN, United Nations. So this particular forum is organized to attain the sustainable development goal 1 and 2 in South Asia. This particular forum was organized by the Asian Farmers Association for Sustainable Rural Development, that is AFA, and La Via Campesina LVC, Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, FAO, then SARC Agriculture Center, SAC, with the facilitation of the SARC Secretariat. So these are all the organizing authority. Similarly, for organizing this particular program, the support was extended by International Fund for Agriculture Development, IFAD, and Swiss Agency for Development and Cooperation, STC, through the MTCP2, that is Medium Term Cooperation Program Phase 2. So these are all the supporters with reference to organizing the first SARC Agri Cooperative Business Forum at Kathmandu during the year 2018. Then another historic thing with reference to KVIC point of view, that is Khadi Village Industry. So this KVIC of Surendranagar, Gujarat, they set up a first silk processing plant in Gujarat the year 2020 in the month of January. So this particular silk processing plant aiming for cost reduction with reference to Gujarati Patola Sari is a world famous one. At present, that is adorned by the rich people. That is because of that higher making cost. So for making up that particular sari, they are getting yarn from the Karnataka and West Bengal. So that the yarn, if they receive the material in the form of yarn, the cost will be more. So in order to reduce that raw material cost, that silk processing plant was started in the Gujarat. So for this purpose, they will receive the cocoon alone from the Karnataka and West Bengal. That cocoon will be processed, so that processed material will be used for making that patola sarees. So this is a very big boost as far as the Gujarati patola saree manufacturer is concerned. So the first silk processing plant of the KVIC established in Surendranagar, Gujarat, January 2020. Then I wish to give you some information regarding that minimum support price, that is MSP. Actually, that MSP is recommended by the Commission for Agricultural Cost and Prices, that is CACP. MSP also announced by the Government of India. MSP is calculated based on the average cost of production. Average cost of production. First MSP was announced for wheat crop the year 1966-67. At present, MSP is announced for 22 mandate crops and one fair and remunerative prices for sugarcane. So that the sugarcane, that MSP given in the name of fair and remunerative prices. So totally now 23 crops are covered under revenue support price. That 22 is a mandate crops and one is a sugarcane, that is a fair remunerative prices. So among the 22 mandate crops, 14 crops are Kharif season crops like paddy, jowar, bajra, maize, ragi, agar, moong, hard, groundnut in shell, soybean, sunflower, sesame, Niger seed and cotton. And 6 crops are the rabi season crop, that is a wheat, barley, gram, lentil, rapeseed, mustard, safflower and so 2 commercial crops like jute and copra. So these are all the 22 plus 1, so totally 23 crops. Apart from that, the NAFED also procured oilseed and pulses from the state government at MSP through price support scheme. So they are also procuring oilseed and pulses by paying that MSP charge fixed by the Government of India through that price support scheme, PSS. So apart from that, the Minister of Tribal Affairs, they also launched minimum support price for minor forest produce and value additions as a component of the Van Dhan scheme. Van Dhan scheme is related to that agroforestry. So under that scheme, that Minister of Tribal Affairs, they fixed a minimum support price for minor forest produce. So these are all the information with regarding MSP. Then some policies and acts related to that marketing and farming. So the Model Contract Farming Act, it was passed on May 2018. The first state to enact law on contract farming in India is Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu is the first state to enact law on contract farming in India. Then model agriculture produce and livestock contract farming and services, that is Promotion and Facilitation Act, drafted in the year May 22, 2018. So the Model Contract Farming Act that normally provide adequate confidence for the farmers and incentives to sponsors to enter into the Contract Act. And the first state in the country to implement land leasing policy. Land leasing policy is Uttarakhand. Agriculture Produce and Livestock Marketing Promotion Facilitation Act was enacted in the year 2017. And another one, Government of India constituted Agri-Export Policy for farmers on 9th December 2018. The main aim of this Agri-Export Policy for farmers is to double the agri export to $60 billion by 2022. That is the main aim of this one. And APIDA is a nodal agency for implementing that Agri-Export Policy. And also that APIDA, they created Farmer Connect portal. So through this portal, they link the FEOs, Farmer Producer Organization, with the exporters. So through this portal, the FPO, they can interact with the exporters. So these are all the things with reference to Agri-Export Policy. So with that, I am completing that first segment. The second segment, I will give you some more information regarding that agriculture economics. Thank you.